let us discuss the parallel combination of capacitors and their equivalent capacitance. We have studied in our early classes that when resistances are connected in parallel, they're all terminals are joined together. Similar to the situation, say if we are given with three capacitors, C1, C2 and C3 are their capacitances. In this situation, if all the left terminal and right terminals of the capacitors are joined together, then we can say across terminals A and B, these three capacitors are connected in parallel. And similar to the case of resistances, here you can say, when capacitors are connected in parallel, their potential difference always remains same. Now, if we wish to calculate the equivalent capacitance of this combination of three capacitors, then we can connect a battery across the combination, say it is of voltage V, along with a switch. And if we close down the switch, we know that the battery will apply a potential difference V across the terminals A and B, and the positive terminal of the battery will pull charges from these three plates, transfer a charge to the other side, and a negative charge will appear over here. So in this situation, say if the charges appearing here are plus Q1, plus Q2 and plus Q3, and the total amount of charge which is flown through the battery from left to right will be negative of Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3, or from right side to left side, it will be delta QF, which can be written as Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3. This because this positive terminal of battery will pull free electrons of the plates and supply to the other side. So as we know, the charges on the inner surfaces of the plates of capacitor are always equal and opposite. So charges on the capacitors will be plus minus plus minus plus minus Q1, Q2, Q3. And as we already discussed, in case of a capacitor, there won't be any charge on the outer surface of the plates of capacitor. Whatever charge we discuss will only be residing on the inner surfaces. Now in this situation, the total amount of charge which has been flown through the battery is this. So here C equivalent we can write, which we already studied, that the total amount of charge flown through the battery divided by the battery potential difference. So here C equivalent can be written as Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 by V. And here as V is the potential difference across each of these capacitors, we can directly write the value of Q1, which is C1V in a steady state, Q2 is C2V and Q3 is C3V. If we substitute the values, you can see the equivalent capacitance will be C1V plus C2V plus C3V by V. Here V gets cancelled out and the equivalent capacitance we are getting is C1 plus C2 plus C3. So always remember, whenever some capacitors are connected in parallel, their equivalent capacitance will be given by the sum of all individual capacitances of the capacitors. You can also keep in mind, like, this was the result we have used in series combination of resistances. Whenever some resistances are connected in series, their equivalent resistance is given as the sum of the individual resistances. Whereas in case of capacitors for parallel combination, we are using this result. Always remember it, because there are many applications you are going to see in future.